The future of color in Premiere Pro is changing. Let's talk about it. More specifically, let's talk about color management. I'm Jason from the Premiere Pro team, and I am really excited to talk to you about something we've been working on for a long time, all new Premiere color management. With the rise of short form video, we're noticing that more and more video editors have to do it all. Editing your videos, color grading, sound mixing, doing your own motion design. We're on a mission with a commitment to make Premiere Pro an even stronger end-to-end editorial platform. And you may have noticed over the past few years, we've been paying a lot of attention and focus into improving the overall performance of Premiere Pro, making it faster, more agile, more flexible. And making a modern color management system for video editors is an important part of that journey. There are dozens of RAW and log formats out there, each of them with their own bespoke color science. And these cameras technically capture more color information than any monitor on Earth is capable of displaying, and they're everywhere, from the camera that shot your latest favorite movie to the iPhone in your pocket. And while dealing with all this complex color science may be a very welcomed task for a craft practitioner like a colorist, these extremely advanced technical workflows are falling on the shoulders of video editors. A mentor of mine used to say, it's not rocket science, but it is color science. Color science is hard, color science is tricky, and we believe it should be a nearly invisible part of your day so you can spend more time telling stories. We built a solution now available in Premiere Pro Beta that makes modern color management approachable and simple and easy for any video editor, no matter your experience, whether you're a first-time Premiere Pro user or a broadcast video engineer at a post house, because it should be simple to get great-looking video in Premiere Pro as soon as you drop footage in your timeline. All this to say, we're serious about color, and this new color management system is just the beginning of a newfound commitment for improving professional color for video editors around the world. Now, we'll get back to that at another time, but for now, here's what's new in the latest version of Premiere Pro Beta. Premiere Color Management automatically normalizes all of your RAW and log footage from nearly any camera to Rec. 709 or HDR without requiring LUTs. We're color managing RAW video in Premiere Pro for the first time, and we've expanded our native log format support to include more formats than ever before. The system revolves around 6 simple presets that surface every time you make a new sequence and are available to adjust in the Lumetri color settings. We do all the heavy lifting and tone mapping for you, with improved algorithms that make your footage look fantastic. And more advanced users have all the tools they need to customize, disable color management, bring your own LUTs. Anything that you liked to do in previous versions of Premiere Pro, you can still do with our new color management system. Also introducing a wide gamut working color space in Premiere Pro for the first time, available in 3 of our new wide gamut presets. Replacing the entire image and color processing pipeline in Premiere Pro from a standard color space like Rec. 709 to an industry standard wide gamut ASUS CCT color space. This is a generational upgrade for flexibility and dynamic range in Premiere Pro. And we've made many of our most popular effects, like Lumetri color correction, color space aware. This means when you choose to use one of our 3 new wide gamut presets, Lumetri is gonna be able to actually take advantage of and utilize all of that glorious RAW and log data in your video. It's gonna give you way more flexibility for balancing your footage, perfecting your skin tones, and really molding and crafting the creative look of your video. All right, check out this shot. We have a lot of dynamic range here. Nothing's clipped in the highlights. I see some cloud detail. Let's go ahead and do a color correction. I'm in the default color management setting right now, Direct 709. So let's hop over to the color tools and make an exposure adjustment. I'm gonna bring exposure all the way down to about 2.5, 2.6. You'll notice that this adjustment is pretty unusable. The sky looks gray. And look at the scopes over here. The highlights are pretty squished. Let's reset the color correction, hop back over to Lumetri settings, and switch to one of the new wide gamut presets. Hop back to the Lumetri color tools and make the same exact adjustment. I'm going to go to exposure, and now in wide gamut, I'm going to bring exposure way back down to 2.5, 2.6. And look at that. Look at all the detail I now have in the sky and the clouds. The shot now looks properly exposed. And I really love this bright sunlight hitting the talent's skin. Now let's compare one more time by going back to settings and flipping between the new wide gamut preset and the new default Direct 709. Which is very reminiscent of how color management would work in previous versions of Premiere Pro. That's an enormous shift in quality and dynamic range. Premiere color management also improves color interop between Premiere Pro and After Effects when using dynamic link. With the new system, After Effects can recognize the Premiere color management settings being sent over and always send back identical color back to Premiere Pro. Everything we covered today is available to try now in the latest version of Premiere Pro Beta. You can download the latest beta version of Premiere Pro in your Creative Cloud app. We are in beta. There are bound to be a few bugs in there. This is the first version of our new color management system, and we have a long roadmap ahead of us. So you'll have to stay tuned as we continue to update this new system as time goes on. Thank you for all of the feedback that has led to this new workflow. We are just getting started when it comes to color, but for now, enjoy Premiere Color Management and happy editing.